In this video, we're going to talk about private cloud. What is it? How does it work? And how do you configure it specifically to make the most of cloud services for your business? G'day, Dan. How are you?
Thanks, Dan.
So let's talk about private cloud. Let's start with what is private cloud versus public cloud? We've covered this before, but just a quick summary to get the ball rolling.
So public cloud is generally available to anybody with a credit card, and it's mostly for things like iCloud or iTunes. It's for uploading your videos and photos and things like that. Whereas private cloud is where businesses come to somebody like us and we maintain their servers and their equipment inside a data center.
So private cloud I could think of as business cloud.
More business cloud rather than consumer cloud, which is public, yeah.
Okay, good. So let's say I'm a business, I'm a small to medium-sized business, and I'm trying to figure out whether I should move some of my data from, let's say, a server sitting in a cupboard to private cloud storage. What's the thought process there?
So the first thing that you would look at is you try and find a provider that can assist you to move it from your server into a data center. And you may also have requirements as to where your data's stored. So some businesses do need to have their data stored in Australia as opposed to
right,
outside of the country.
For compliance reasons, legal reasons.
That's right. So whether it's a legal compliance or maybe just compliance through the particular association that regulates their industry.
Okay.
But either way, they may need to have their data stored in Australia. So private cloud is fantastic for businesses that want to ensure their data always stays here. But there's also businesses that need to be able to run certain applications which don't run well in a public cloud environment.
Okay, so let's give a specific example of that. I think you mentioned that you were working with an architecture firm and you needed to come up with a solution that was a little bit outside the box.
That's right. So we dealt with an architect firm that needed to run Revit, which is a 3D CAD application. They needed to deliver that to staff that sat in four different locations across Australia, so in four different cities. What we ended up building for them was a centralised server that we could load Revit onto, which sat in our data centre in the private cloud. And they were then able to connect to that server from not only their offices, but when they were out sitting in front of the client, they were then able to connect into their Revit application and be able to do everything that they could as if they were sitting in their desk in the office, but they could do that from any location anywhere.
So that wasn't actually, so to speak, a Revit cloud version. That was you guys using cloud services to come up with something that hadn't really been done very much before.
Yeah, that's right. And the Revit in the cloud wasn't doing what this particular business wanted to do, so that's why they wanted us to bring their application into a data center. And we accelerated their application and we made it work effectively for their staff so that they could be sharing resources with people in Brisbane and Melbourne. Even people that were sitting overseas were able to connect into the data center and be able to access their CAD drawing.
So that sounds very flexible. What are the implications of private cloud computing when it comes to backups and security?
So with regard to backups and security in the private cloud, we generally take backups of customers' data that span across multiple data centers. So if their data is sitting in one location, we'll generally back it up into at least one, maybe two other different locations, just to make sure that if ever there's a problem in that data center, that they've always got their data available to them. When it comes to security, generally the security that we would put into the private cloud is much greater and much stronger than what a small business could afford. So we take those costs of security and we bring that across all the customers in the private cloud rather than having each individual customer needing their own high-end security devices.
Okay, now that makes sense to me. What's the process here? If someone wanted to call you and potentially work with SaberVox, what's the process of figuring out what they should be doing for their business? Do you sit with them and have a yarn for half an hour? How do people kind of get along that path?
Yeah, look, it is different for every business as to what they would want to move into the cloud. So yeah, we would generally come out and we'd sit with them and we'd spend time really just finding out about what they do in the business. Even before we talk about the computers and the technology, tell me about the business and what does the business do? How is the business growing? Do you want to grow in new markets, into new areas? Tell us more about what the business is doing. Then we basically take that and we then build technology around it to enable that.
All right, that makes a lot of sense. Sounds like a good thing to look for in an IT services company.
It does.
All right, terrific. Thanks very much. For those of you who'd like to find out more or perhaps talk to Dan directly, please visit us online at sabervox.com.au. Delighted to take an email or call and talk to you directly.